Miniature bolt cutters are very capable and a must-have tool in my shop. So the question is that $7 set of bolt cutters just as good as a pair that costs $60? Let's find out.
In the first test, we'll see how much squeezing force it takes to cut through a 16-penny nail. Then we'll see how the bolt cutters perform cutting through a deck screw. Unfortunately, not all the bolt cutters will survive cutting through a drill bit. Things really begin to come apart when the bolt cutters attempt to cut through an Allen key. At a bargain price of only $7, the least expensive brand we'll be testing is made by Genford. All the miniature bolt cutters we'll be testing are 8 inches in length, made of high-quality 55 alloy steel, integral heat treatment, and high-frequency quench hardening. It claims to be well-designed, durable, can cut hard and soft metals very easily. We're going to test that. The Genford is made in China. The Genford bolt cutters weigh 274 grams. In the first test, we'll see how much squeezing force it takes to cut through a 16-penny galvanized nail using a tester that I put together. Once the bolt cutters are clamped onto the holder, I'll slide the front piece with the two bolts towards the bolt cutters. The two bolts will hold the nail against the bolt cutters to allow for maximum leverage. To keep the nails from becoming a projectile once it's cut, I'll attach locking pliers to the very end of the nail. The hydraulic press will be applying force to the very end of the handle. And the Genford needed 120 pounds of squeezing force to cut through the galvanized 16-penny nail. At a price of $10, or just $3 more than the Genford, is this performance tool brand. Precision milled and drop forged steel jaws. Rubber hand grips for comfort and control. Drop forged heat treatment alloy steel construction handles. Durable protective enamel paint. The performance tool bolt cutters are made in China. Performance tool is quite a bit lighter than the Genford at 235 grams. And the performance tool bolt cutters perform slightly better than the Genford, cutting through the nail at 114 pounds. At a price of $15, is this Tekton brand. Forged and hardened alloy steel jaws. Compound cutting action requires less effort. Rolled steel handles with cushioned non-slip rubber grips. Cuts bolts, chains, threaded rod, and heavy gauge wire. The Tekton bolt cutters are made in China. The Tekton bolt cutters weigh 265 grams. And the Tekton bolt cutters move into the lead over performance tool by cutting through the nail at only 88 pounds of squeezing force. At a price of $18, is this Great Neck brand. Drop forged hardened alloy steel jaws. Compound cutting action. Cuts all sorts of things, including chain links, bolts, screws, fencing wire, and brads. Rolled steel handles. Made in China. The Great Neck bolt cutters weigh 248 grams. The Great Neck bolt cutters performed about the same as the performance tool at 112 pounds, then move into second position. At a price of $20, is this KC Professional brand. Manufactured using state-of-the-art forging techniques. Head riveted to steel handles. Made using the finest machining processes available. Heat-treated tool steel head. There's no information on the packaging regarding where these bolt cutters are made. The KC Professional is the heaviest yet at 290 grams. And the KC Professional moves into a two-way tie for second place with the Great Neck bolt cutters at 112 pounds. Also at a price of $20, the same price as the KC Professional, is this Workpro brand. Classic lever fulcrum design. Powder-coated jaw for sure, efficient cutting, and long life. Drop-forged chrome moly steel. Ergonomic bi-material anti-slip grips. Ideal for cutting wires, bolts, rods, and rivets. The Workpro brand is made in China. The Workpro is the heaviest yet at 333 grams. And the Workpro bolt cutters perform nearly as well as the Tekton at 91 pounds to move into second position. Also at a price of $20 is this Kobalt brand. Ideal for cutting rods, bolts, concrete form ties, and fencing wire. Drop forged chrome moly steel blades for strength and durability. Overmolded comfort grip. Hassle-free lifetime guarantee. The Kobalt bolt cutters are made in China. The Kobalt weighs 280 grams. The Kobalt brand needed quite a bit of force to cut through the nail at 131 pounds to move into last position. At a price of $22 is this ARES brand. Induction hardened cutting blades rated over 58 HRC. Heavy duty chrome moly construction. Leverage system designed to cut heavy duty wire, bolts, nails, and rivets. There's no information on the packaging where this product is made. The ARES weighs 294 grams. And the ARES bolt cutters made easy work of the 16-penny nail at 77 pounds and moves into first place over the Tekton brand. At a price of $27, is this Capri Tools brand. Easily cut through wires, threaded rods, bolts, and chains. Double heat-treated chrome moly blades cut through materials with a vengeance. High leverage design gives you more force with less effort. Ergonomic grips make cutters comfortable and secure. The Capri Tools bolt cutters are made in Taiwan. The Capri bolt cutters are the heaviest yet at 357 grams. And the Capri Tool bolt cutters made very easy work of the 16-penny nail at only 61 pounds to take the lead from ARES. Very impressive. At a price of $28, is this HK Porter brand. Induction hardened cutting edges for ultimate durability. Recessed notch blade holds cutting material very close for extreme cutting power. Cuts very hard steel. We're going to test that. Easy to clean industrial plastic dip handle grips. The HK Porter bolt cutters are made in China. The HKP weighs 343 grams. And the HK Porter Bolt Cutters needed 77 pounds of squeezing force to cut through the nail and moves into a two-way tie with the ARES brand. At a price of $31, is this Klein Tools brand? The Klein Tools is a diagonal cutter and not a bolt cutter, but it'll be interesting to see how they compare. The Klein Tools diagonal cutters can cut ACSR screws, nails, and most hardened wire. High leverage design, 36% greater cutting power than other plier designs. Short jaws and bevel cutting edges permit close cutting of wire. Induction hardened cutting knives for long life. The Klein Tools pliers are made in USA. The Klein Tools weighs 292 grams. Even though the diagonal cutters made by Klein Tools just don't offer nearly as much leverage advantage compared to the bolt cutters, they still perform very well at 102 pounds. At a price of $33, is this Gedore brand? The Gedore brand advertises these cutters as bolt cutters. Induction hardened cutter. Two one-sided micro grooves prevent cutting material from gliding. Made of a special hardened and tempered steel. Ergonomic, beautiful handle design for repetitive, fatigue-free use. The Gedore brand is made in Austria. The Gedore bolt cutters weigh 262 grams. The Gedore cutters needed 127 pounds or 25 pounds more than the Klein Tools to make the cut. At a price of $44, is this NWS brand? Power transmission with optimal leverage for easy and effortless work. Precision cutting edge for bolts, nails, and rivets. Inductively hardened. Made of a special tool steel forged and oil hardened. Cutting edge hardness to approximately 62 HRC. The NWS brand is made in Germany. The NWS weighs 305 grams. And the NWS cutters perform well at 82 pounds to move into the third position. At a price of $59, the most expensive brand we'll be testing is made by Knipex. Applies up to 20 times more hand force for superior cutting power. Forged from chrome vanadium steel, this mini bolt cutter can cut through more than you ever thought possible, up to a quarter inch diameter with ease. The Knipex brand is made in Germany, designed to cut soft as well as hard steel. And the Knipex is the heaviest yet at 369 grams. And the Knipex performed very well at 62 pounds, finishing just 1 pound behind the Capri Tools brand. So the Capri Tools bolt cutters came out on top at 61 pounds, but the Knipex performed nearly as well at 62. ARES and HK Porter tied for third at 77 pounds and NWS 82 pounds. Nails are pretty soft compared to deck screws, so let's see how the bolt cutters perform cutting through this number 10 deck screw. And it took a lot of squeezing force for the Genford to make the cut through the number 10 deck screw at 166 pounds. Unfortunately, the Genford experienced a small amount of damage to the cutting knives, but they're still in decent shape. The Performance Tool Bolt Cutters are the lightest at 235 grams, and they weren't able to make the cut through the deck screw. Unfortunately, the pliers are badly bent. The cutting knives also experienced quite a bit of damage. The Tekton performed nearly as well as the Genford Bolt Cutters at 168 pounds. Just like the Genford, the cutting knives experienced a small amount of wear and tear, but they're still in pretty good shape. And the Great Neck Bolt Cutters move into first place over the Genford at 152 pounds. The cutting knives look the best yet with very little wear. And the KC Professional needed 181 pounds or 29 more pounds of squeezing force to make the cut compared to the Great Neck bolt cutters. The cutting knives are still in good shape, but they appear to have a little bit more wear compared to the Great Neck cutters. The Workpro made the cut at 127 pounds or 25 pounds less than the Great Neck cutters to move into first place. The cutters experienced a small amount of wear. The Kobalt cut through the deck screw at 158 pounds or 31 more pounds than the Workpro to move into third position. The cutting knives held up really well with very little visible wear and tear. The ARES bolt cutters performed nearly the same as the Workpro at 128 pounds. The cutters held up better than most of the other brands with very little visible wear. The Capri Tool bolt cutters easily cut through the deck screw at only 89 pounds. Very impressive! The cutting knives are still in great shape. The Porter bolt cutters also performed very well, cutting through the deck screw at 122 pounds. Comparing the Porters to the Capri Tools, the cutting knives did experience a little bit more wear and tear. Once again, the Klein Tools diagonal cutters outperformed some of the bolt cutters at 162 pounds. The cutting knives still look nearly as good as new. The Gedore cutters needed 25 more pounds of squeezing force compared to Klein Tools, finally making the cut at 189 pounds. The cutting knives still look nearly as good as new. The NWS made easy work of the deck screw, making the cut at 113 pounds to move into second position. The cutters are still in great shape. Just like the NWS, the Knipex also needed 113 pounds of force to make the cut. The cutting knives in the Knipex are still in great shape. Once again, the Capri Tools came in on top at 89 pounds, making very easy work of the deck screw. NWS and Knipex tied for second at 113 pounds, HK Porter 122, and Workpro 127 pounds. Assessing wear and damage is highly subjective, but about half the brands received the best possible score of 1 for very little damage, and most of the other brands are rated as 2 for minor damage. Cutting through a 3/16 inch drill bit will really put the bolt cutters to the test. And the drill bit was just way too much for the Genford. The Genford made it to 178 pounds before one of the jaws on the bolt cutters broke. The cutting knives are pretty blunt to begin with, but they held up fairly well with only minor damage to the cutting knives. The Tekton performed nearly the same as the Genford on the deck screw, and it performed nearly the same as the Genford on this test with the handle bending at 190 pounds. Just as it did with the Genford, the drill bit did cause minor damage to the cutting knives. And the great neck bolt cutters have done the best so far, making it to 268 pounds before finally giving up. And the great neck just about made it all the way through the drill bit before the jaws became bent. The cutting knives also held up a little bit better than the Genford and the Tekton. And the KC Professional gave up at 220 pounds and they just weren't able to cut through the drill bit. And the KC Professionals did make a lot of progress cutting through the drill bit. The handles are badly bent, but the cutting knives are still in pretty good shape. So none of the previous five brands were able to cut through the drill bit, but the $20 Workpro bolt cutters made easy work of the drill bit at only 168 pounds. The cutting knives in the Workpro are still in great shape. And the Kobalt cost about the same as the KC Professional and the Workpro. Unfortunately, the drill bit was just too much for the Kobalt bolt cutters. The handle became bent at 198 pounds. However, the cutting knives are still in great shape. And the Workpro and the ARS have been performing nearly the same throughout the showdown, and they perform nearly the same this time as well. 166 pounds for the ARS are just 2 pounds better than the Workpro to move into the lead. And the cutting knives on the ARS are still in great shape. And the Capri Tools has finished in first place in the previous two rounds of competition, and it just moved into the lead again this time with a very impressive 134 pounds to make the cut. So 32 pounds less than the ARES to make the cut. The cutting knives are still in great shape. And the HK Porters perform well, cutting through the drill bit at 177 pounds to move into the fourth position behind the Workpro bolt cutters. The cutting knives are still in good shape, but they appear to have a little bit more wear and tear compared to the Workpro, ARES, and Capri Tools. The Klein Tools advertises their product as wire cutters and they don't offer as much leverage as some of the other brands. However, they still perform very well at 177 pounds. The cutting knives are still in really good shape with very little visible wear and tear. And the Gedore cutters require quite a bit more squeezing force than the Klein Tools brand, but they held up just fine, finally making the cut at 228 pounds. The cutting knives on the Gedore are very sharp and they're still in great condition. The NWS has a pretty big leverage advantage over the Klein Tools and the Gedore brand, and it really helped. 190 pounds to cut through the drill bit. The cutting knives are still in great shape. The jaw opening on the Knipex is a little bit smaller than some of the other brands, and the drill bit just isn't able to rest as close to the pivot point as several of the other brands, preventing it from having the same leverage advantage. And the Knipex made the cut at 217 pounds. The cutting knives in the Knipex are still in great shape. Once again, the Capri Tools bolt cutters came out on top at 134 pounds. ARES finished in second at 166. Workpro 168, HK Porter 177, and Klein Tools 179 pounds. Allen keys are made of very hard tool steel. Let's see if any of the bolt cutters can make the cut. And the Workpro bolt cutters made it all the way to 336 pounds before finally giving up. Unfortunately, the lower jaw on the Workpro broke when trying to make the cut. The cutting knives were just way too soft to make the cut, and there's quite a bit of damage. And the ARES held up even longer than the Workpro, finally snapping at 417 pounds. Just like the Workpro, the lower jaw on the ARES broke. However, the ARES did make a little bit more progress than the Workpro at cutting through the Allen key. Just like the Workpro, the cutting knives on the ARES experienced a tremendous amount of damage. The Capri Tools performed very well throughout the testing, but it wasn't able to make the cut through the Allen key. The lower jaw finally broke at 346 pounds. However, it definitely seems to have made the most progress cutting through the Allen key. Just like the Workpro and the ARES, the Capri Tools experienced quite a bit of damage. And the HK Porters made it to 419 pounds, the most yet, before finally giving up. The Porters left a pretty large gouge in the Allen key. However, the cutting knives experienced a tremendous amount of damage. And the Klein Tools diagonal cutters are definitely built to take a lot of hard use and abuse, but they finally gave up at 421 pounds, or just 2 pounds more than the HK Porters. The rivet on the Klein Tools broke, but the cutting knives are in slightly better shape than the bolt cutters. And the Gedore brand made it all the way to 433 pounds before they finally broke. The main body on the pliers broke near the pivot point. The cutting knives in the Gedore experienced about the same amount of damage as the Klein Tools. And the NWS has a big leverage advantage compared to most of the other brands, but they just didn't take nearly as much abuse, giving up at 232 pounds. Just like the Klein Tools and the Gedore, the cutting knives held up a little bit better than average. And the Allen key was too tough for the Knipex as well, but it made it to 338 pounds before the lower jaw snapped. Of all the bolt cutter brands, the cutting knives and the Knipex definitely held up by far the best with the least amount of damage. If you're looking for bolt cutters that can take the most pressure, the Gedore came in on top at 433 pounds. Klein Tools came in second at 421, Porter 419, ARES 417, Capri Tools 346, and Knipex 338 pounds. While assessing damage is highly subjective, the cutting knives of the Knipex definitely seem to be the most durable and experience the least amount of damage. The Klein Tools, Gedore, and NWS also performed very well.
When you consider the performance, I'm really impressed with the Capri Tools, and that would be my number one choice. price. I also like ARES as well as Workpro when you consider the price. They're very affordable and they perform very well. Regarding which brand is the most durable, definitely the Knipex. The cutters on the Knipex are going to last a really long time. All the videos in this channel, including this one, are viewer suggested. So if you have a video idea, I hope you'll take time to leave a comment. Thanks so much for watching. Please take care and I look forward to next time.